You are a vital piece to our work here.
Secure the future of this.
Welcome back, everyone. It is Amelia. I hope you are fine. The Bad Batch Season 3 final helps establish a timeline for Palpatine's precious project Necromancer, leading to its mention in The Mandalorian. The Bad Batch Season 3 final has finally brought the series to a close, while also providing a rough timeline for Emperor Palpatine's precious project Necromancer. First mentioned in The Mandalorian Season 3, Project Necromancer promised to explain how Palpatine somehow returned in Star Wars, The Rise of Skywalker. Creating a simple clone of himself was easy, but Palpatine's pride drove him to push cloning science even further than the Kaminoans had. He did not want to create a mere clone of himself. Instead, Project Necromancer existed to craft an even better clone than the original. According to the Bad Batch Season 3 ending, Palpatine's main goal with Project Necromancer was to create a clone with a higher M count than his own, thereby increasing his connection to the Force. If successful, he could then transfer his essence or his soul into the improved clone and continue ruling the Empire from a younger and more powerful body. To this end, Palpatine gave Dr. Hemlock all the resources necessary. Yet Dr. Hemlock discovered that artificially increasing M count was no easy task, as cloning almost always came with a decrease in M count from the original to the clone. Thanks to the efforts of the Bad Batch, Palpatine's Project Necromancer was ultimately thwarted. During Omega's escape, Hunter and Crosshair defeated Dr. Hemlock, putting an end to the mastermind of the program. And even though Palpatine assured Hemlock that Project Necromancer was one of his most vital pieces to his empire, Palpatine seemingly allowed Gunner Tarkin to shutter the operation after Hemlock's death. With Mount Tantis and its secrets in ruins, its leader in his grave, and no research left to follow up on, the Batch set Palpatine back to square one in his search for immortality. While the Batch instigated most of the destruction of Hemlock's base on Tantis, it was ultimately the Kaminoan Nala Se who dealt the final blow to Project Necromancer. Rather than see her people's research continue to be misused by the Empire, she sacrificed herself to blow up the databanks on Tantis. Had she failed to destroy Hemlock's research, it's likely Tarkin would have cleaned up Hemlock's mess and carried on with the program where he'd left off. But because of Nala Se, the Empire abandoned Project Necromancer for a time, though inevitably, it was revived later. The Bad Batch Season 3 closed the door on Project Necromancer during the Imperial era. The Mandalorian Season 3 reopened the door. During a meeting of the Imperial Shadow Council, Grand Admiral Thrawn's right-hand man, Captain Gilard Pellion, mentioned Project Necromancer. At this point, Commandant Brendel HOX was now in charge of the program. According to the Imperials, Project Necromancer was meant to reinstate stability and leadership back into the scattered remnants of the Empire. In other words, the project aimed at cloning Emperor Palpatine in order for him to return to his rule. Give me some ideas related to my video in comments on below if you like this video, and subs for more upcoming videos.